Ship's log, February 18, 1854. U.S. Navy Far East Squadron. Matthew Perry commanding. We have come to Japan to sign a treaty which will open diplomatic relations between our countries. For centuries, Japan has successfully repelled any intrusion by the outside world. Now, the treaty is to change all that. In effect, it will mark the end of Japan's old tradition of isolation. The shogun, the country's absolute ruler, and most of his followers have come to accept this as inevitable. But there are those who do not agree and will resist the opening of Japan to foreigners at any cost.
Ah! Commodore spreading it on thick.
Yeah, old Bruin's as smooth as glass. Those Japanese better watch themselves signing the treaty tomorrow.
Well, Rob, my boy, what do you think of this fine chowdown, huh?
Mr. Johnson, as a commissioned officer, I suggest you learn to address me correctly.
Yes, sir, Mr. Barr.
That boy's neck is as stiff as a Marine's collar.
You shut your face or I'll squeeze your neck shut.
Uncle is pressing his point.
Well, sir, it certainly is a problem having my mother's brother on the same ship.
As I understand it, that was the only reason your mother let you join the Navy at your age.
She made him promise to look after me, so... Oh.
He means well.
Yeah, I guess so. But now, as an officer, I must command respect, no matter who it is.
Respect isn't commanded, Mr. Burr. It's earned.
I'll follow your example, sir,
well,
but...
to God, country, and mother's milk.
Sir.
25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. Thank you very much.
This is truly amazing. A box that captures your image.
That is a daguerreotype, and we are very honored to bring to your country the first camera.
The gifts you have brought are too much. A steam machine.
The quarter-scale Norris locomotive.
Wires that carry messages across miles.
It's a telegraph. Very handy.
We are in your debt.
The fellow's right, sir. Their gifts are of little value. Bales of rice, writing boxes, and some silk cloth.
There may be one gift worthy of your president. It is a unique blade, the treasure of the nation.
A blade?
It is a great sword. The blade of Bushido.
A sword?
A work of art.
That I have never heard an edged weapon spoken of in quite that way.
To the Japanese, a sword is of spiritual character. The code of Bushido says a samurai warrior should live and die sword in hand.
I confess I find that a bit excessive, but as a military man, I will drink to its zeal. Kanpai. Join America in the modern world. Bravo, huh? Yeah. Where is that officer who was learning Japanese?
Right here, sir.
They're talking about something that...
A Bushido blade has been stolen.
Reason! Arms!
What did he look like?
He had a scar over his left eye, sir.
It is one of the Mito clan, sent by the Lord Yamato.
This man an outlaw, a thief?
Lord Yamato is a leader of those opposed to opening Japan.
Now, those people can be convinced that we mean to bring Japan into the 19th century for her own good.
No, they are committed to their old ways. Assassination, violence.
Why take the sword?
It was a gift meant for your president. They seek to embarrass us.
The sword is not important. The only thing that's important is the signing of that treaty.
I'm sorry. That is impossible until the sword is returned. It would embarrass the Shogun.
Well, this is damn well selling.
He seems dead set, sir.
And I should know better than to argue with the Japanese about saving face. All right, then, by God. I will send the Marines in to retrieve that sword.
Company ready to move, sir.
No. Foreigners cannot go into the countryside. The Shogun has forbidden it.
It is I who will go.
Now, who the hell is this?
Prince Ido. He commands the guard here.
It was my men who were to guard the blade. I will avenge them, or I will join them with my own hand.
On the day that happens, then I too must join you.
Now I will not hear you talk about suicide over this damn sword.
We have no choice if it is not returned.
The blade will have been taken to the Lord Yamato's castle.
How far is that?
It is none of your concern. Do not interfere. It is a matter between samurai. It is our code. I must go. Alone.
I'll be glad to give you instructions in our code, sir.
Captain Hawk, we serve no further purpose here. Move your troops out.
Company!
Negotiation? This business of the silly damn sword spoils it all. Ah! Now, the president has ordered that we sail with the treaty signed not later than the end of April. If we don't retrieve that damn sword, we sail home empty-handed. Captain, I don't have to remind you that others wait. The Russians regard Japan as their own backyard. No secret. Their fleet is sitting in Port Arthur right now. If we fall on our asses, the Russians will be here to negotiate with weapons, and that we cannot allow to happen.
Why not let me go after this, Ito? If he fails, I'll follow through.
And you heard the Shogun's orders. Nobody from this party is allowed inland. We're restricted to this village, this port.
I also heard that we weren't allowed to steam up Yokohama Bay. And we did. That we weren't allowed to come ashore any place but Nagasaki. And we did.
Captain, I get your point.
We might go ashore for more surveying of the treaty ground to
extend its perimeter, say, and get lost.
Captain, how many men might you need?
10 Marines, I could take the Shogun's palace.
Captain, we are not here to start a war. The minimum...
Say 5.
Say 2. And make them Navy.
Navy?
And help yourself to the cigars.
Thank you. One for each sailor.
Captain, sir?
Yes. Pass the word to Mr. Burr?
Yes, sir.
Well?
He'll report at once, sir.
Sit down, Johnson.
Thank you, sir.
I've been ordered to go after this, Bushido sword on the quiet. The Japanese are against the mission. I'm to take 2 Navy. I've been thinking of, Mr. Burr. Commodore is impressed with his studying of their language. I think it might prove useful. Bosun?
Well, he is an eager officer, sir. He's a man for the rules. Oh, it's true. He's been studying up on their lingo. I've heard him speak it.
Go ahead.
Well, the thing is, sir, he has no experience in action. He's just a boy,
no,
really.
I know, Johnson. Enough of the wet nurse. He's not a boy. He's a naval officer. Commodore wants him. I want him. Let go. Give him his chance.
Yes, sir.
As for the other Navy, we must balance out with a man of experience, someone who can knock heads and shout down these paper houses. I've been thinking of the squadron's no-hold-barred heavyweight champion. What do you think?
Yes, sir.
Get your gear ready in an order. We shove off on the hour.
Now, listen, Horse. I'm a sailor, not a cavalryman.
Mr. Burr, see if you can understand this gibberish. This man is supposed to guide us.
From what I understand, he said the prince left about 2 hours ago.
Why didn't he say so?
The horse is broken. Never trusted a horse. Look at his eye. He's out to get me. He doesn't even obey any of my commands.
Well, Bosun, gotta speak to him in Japanese.
If I can't understand it, how do you expect a horse to?
Bosun, Mr. Bird, check your gear. Let's get on with it. Mr. Bird.
He says the prince just passed through the village about an hour ago.
Through the village?
Mura Toru?
Fukani michi nai.
He says there's no other way.
All right, gentlemen, mount up. Be alert.
Who do you suppose everyone is?
Right. Can't have seen many Americans. Yeah, what's this? Where's that guide got to? Mr. Burr, fall back. Single file. Betrayed us! Forward!
What about Mr. Burr?
Find him! I'll catch up with the prince!
Yes, sir! Robin! Robin!
Tori?
Have guns, matchlocks, but nothing like this.
These guns were designed for the Texas Rangers. They're death to Indians or samurai. No disrespect intended, sir, but you seem in need of help. Now, I've been ordered to go after this sword, and I intend to carry out that order. We can travel as companions or not, but if you mean to stop me, now's your big chance.
Another like me.
Blast that horse, bolting.
Oh, my poor feet.
What ship are you off, mate?
Steam frigate, Powhatan.
When did she go down?
Down? What are you talking about? She's anchored in Yokohama Bay, along with the rest of the Far East squadron.
They let you anchor?
Does that mean there's war?
Old man, lay off. As you can see, sir, we're all anxious. We've all been shipwrecked on this cursed island, some of us more than 2 years. The Nippons will let us know nothing about the outside world.
Well, I can tell you this. Commodore Perry brought a treaty to be signed, and it insists on the right to shipwreck men.
Oh, thank God. By God, it's about time! This is good news. Come over here. Sit down. I was harpooner on the Yankee whaler Sultan. She went down 2 years ago off the Japan coast.
Breezy. Sanui. Sanui.
Your ships are in Yokohama Harbor. How do you come to be in this rotten hole?
On orders. I was riding inland with a captain of Marines and a naval officer. We were attacked and separated.
This is a bad time for all foreigners.
We were on our way to a castle of a Lord Yamato. Where would that be?
I've heard of it. Seven Re, 18 miles from here.
Could you draw me a chart of it?
You can't miss it. Just keep to the coast. It overlooks the sea.
Oh, no!
No! Through!
Stop shoving,
will you?
What is
it? Okay.
Torture?
Almost as bad. Baths.
Baths?
Once a week, we are taken against our will to a bathhouse and forced to immerse completely in steaming water.
Once a week?
These Nippons, crazy for bathing, they're out of all the time.
But my God, don't they know it's unhealthy?
What's more, the men and women bathe together. I saw them do it.
By blue, Peter! You'll not get me in that thing!
Easy, Navy. If you resist, they'll beat you down with their clubs.
What's the matter with you people? Are you sailors? Have you forgotten how to fight?
Navy's right! Let's bust up, boys!
Much further.
Not far. Ahead, there is a shrine.
I'm hoping that you feel well.
You speak English?
Yes, thank you. I'm famous for that. My name is Enjiro.
But how?
Many years ago, as a small tad, I was blown to sea in my fish boat. After many hours, I was rescued by a large ship that chases whales. I stayed with those people 6 years, visiting many places, New Bedford, Mystic, even Boston.
Boston? That's my home. Sit down, please.
Oh, I see you still suffer.
No, it's nothing. It's a flux. It'll pass.
I come from another village near this one. Yuki knew of me and sent for my assistance.
Yuki?
Yuki is the girl who found you. She says you speak our language.
I've been struggling with it, but I thought I failed. She doesn't answer me.
You must understand, she's very shy. And the country girl. To her, it was as though you fell from the sky.
She saved my life.
You said a word to her in the boat. Tori. Bird?
That's as close as I could come to my own name. Robin.
Ah, I see. She took it for a sign to have her bird, the Cormorant, find you, named Bird.
I am an officer off the American ship Powhatan, anchored in Yokohama Bay. We are searching for the castle of Lord Yamato.
We know the Lord well.
Yamato took a sword that was to be sent to our president. Myself and two others were sent to bring it back.
Three? Oh, that would be very interesting to see.
Could you guide me there?
This would be very difficult. The village elders prefer not to know you're here. It might bring Lord Yamato's samurai down on all of them.
Sir, as a representative of my government, I must carry out orders. It is my duty to find the others. Failing that, I'll go alone if necessary and present my demands to Yamato.
Of course, of course. But first, perhaps it would be better if you could walk.
You said the prince was your cousin, right?
That is right.
I don't want to offend you, but you don't appear to be Japanese.
My father was a foreigner. I was born in a trader's compound in Nagasaki.
Really? Interesting.
It was a disgrace. My mother was from a respected samurai family. After I was born, she killed herself. If it hadn't been for my father, she would have killed me too.
Killed you too? Terrible.
No. It is what's done. I stayed with my father until he was killed in revenge. Then, as a child, I was taken in by Prince Ido's clan, my mother's family.
How'd you come to be here?
Lord Yamato and Prince Ido's family were engaged in bitter feuding. To ensure peace, hostages were exchanged. I came here. It's where I learned to be a samurai.
A woman samurai?
In that way, I can find death in battle and avenge the dishonor of my Western blood.
What? Got nothing to be ashamed of? Done nothing. What do you know about the West? It's a modern wonder. Railroads carrying hundreds of people at great speed and comfort and safety. You ever see one? Miraculous. Factories, mills, thousands of new things every day, making work for everybody. Tall buildings, big cities, money, millions. Everything.
You talk of numbers, things. We think of the beauty of the landscape, the texture of silk, a flower.
Well, now this is a change. First the fire-breathing samurai ready to die for honor. Now the delicate lady talking flowers.
Is it impossible to be both in your country?
Good, because you must leave at once.
Now?
Two of Yamato's samurai were just in the village. Someone must have reported you here.
Yuki, Fune usuku dasunda.
Hi.
Go with Yuki. It's all right. Yuki knows where to go.
Well, what in the devil have you fellas been eating? What do you want from me? Wrestling, is it?
Not looking for us?
No. Guess not.
We cannot wait any longer. I will lead you into the castle by a secret way. But we must go now. And no horses.
Is that Ito's plan to sneak into the castle and steal the sword?
Do you imagine that you can walk in among 100 samurai and demand it back? Your gunboats are not here. You must decide to go now or return to your ships.
I'll go. Just let me get some rest, woman.
Turn over. Turn over. I will massage your back.
Another skill. Stopping us.
It is what they believe in. They mean to protect their old ways.
And you don't intend to follow the old ways.
For centuries, Japan has stood still. Now, we must join the modern world. Yamato and his kind are finished. I know you must go. There is one thing I can do that may help you in this. You fought bravely in battle and saved my life. Only a samurai can have this. It is our code. This is for you. In this way, you will have to be treated as an equal. As a samurai.
I don't know what the Commodore would say or the U.S. Marines, but I thank you. I surely do.
We must leave now.
What about food for them?
It is a disgrace for a samurai to feel hunger.
Some code that demands honor of a man's belly.
You are a samurai now. If you wish to understand what that means, then you must begin to think in our way. For us, death sharpens life, and discipline sharpens pleasure.
I'd like to think I was disciplined in pleasure.
Yamato's castle. My servant Mitsu is to leave a sign in front of the door. That will let us in.
Shogun's commander is here, Commodore. Unofficially.
Unofficially?
Yes, sir.
Prince Ido has been shot.
And the others?
Missing.
Bungled, all bungled. Now, sir, what do we do?
What can we do? You dare not admit to your government that you sent your men into our countryside. I cannot admit. I know this to my government. And my friend, that is not all. Our agents in Port Arthur report the Russian fleet has sailed for Japan.
How can we sign that treaty without the sword?
I could sign, Commodore, but the Shogun would lose face. And only my life would wipe that out.
Cast off the tender!
Our calling operation finished.
Yes, sir. The bunkers are full. We can get underway at any time.
My uniform. My saber.
Samurai no shitaku wo. Samurai desu.
を味ずにアメリカ人を侍にして、わしの前に連れてくると。そのアメリカ人を連れてこい。顔が見たいわ。
the name of the U.S. government, President Franklin Pierce, and Commodore Perry, I demand the return of the stolen sword, the Bushido Blade, under the threat of harsh reprisals.
You remain alive only because Prince Ido made you a samurai. If you wish to take the Bushido Blade, then take it as a samurai. Fight for it.
A duel? Is he talking about a duel?
Yes, a duel.
Fine. We'll settle it like gentlemen, but I want to use my saber, not this pig sticker.
Use what you wish. My champion will use the blade.
Champion?
Ho!
A great lord, such as Yamato, never fights himself. Instead, he offers his first champion. He offers you the best.
Damn decent of him.
Such a simple way of life, Yuki. Could you understand what I really want to do?
Yuki!
Uncle!
Robbie!
Bosun, what happened to your uniform?
Oh, well, sir, I was captured by the Nippons, and I got away as best I could.
Where's Captain Hawk?
I lost track of him, sir, looking for you. This fella here says he got as far as the castle.
Is that right, Injuro?
It is not hard to recognize one of you among all of us. He's been seen.
Well, then we've got to push on and meet him at once.
It is down this river. We'll take Yuki's boat.
All right, then, Bosun, let's get underway.
Yes, sir.
Oh, Yuki, friend, not there.
Hi.
Indra, does she understand that she has to go back to her village?
I have told her. It is very dangerous for her here.
Yuki, when this is over, I'll try and visit you. Anata no mura. Mi Iku. Arigato. Kore. Dozo. It was taken when I became an officer. It's a pretty good likeness, I think.
Lobby.
Mr. Bird, please.
I better go.
Hawk-sama. It is the custom for a warrior to have his pleasures before a battle.
I find that very difficult to argue with.
Dozo.
Dozo? Till tomorrow. When it's over, we'll walk out of here with that pesky blade.
It will not be easy. Baron Zen is a Bushi. They believe the blade, not the person, does the killing.
Please, spare me. The best swordsman will win, whatever the style.
Perhaps it would be instructive if I showed you our style.
You'll show me.
This is Sudesuri, cutting off the sleeve, to slice off a hand.
Bravo, thanks for the lesson, but it's hardly what I'd call the art of fencing. Why do they carry two swords anyway? What's the smaller one for?
To cut off the head, as a trophy.
Seems to me there's an excess of that disgusting habit. It's a barbaric practice.
That is what the Luther can expect tomorrow.
Enough about heads and swords.
I only want you to understand that this duel is very serious. Baron Zen.
I want you to understand that I can take care of myself tomorrow.
We have a saying.
No more sayings. No more lessons.
The castle is just beyond this forest.
Wait here.
I will try and find out where your captain is.
I say, we pound on the door and damn well demand our rights.
We're U.S. Navy.
I'm sure our flag will be respected. Maybe we dare. We want to bring
May them. I be permitted to point out that we are only three?
Prince Edo.
Thank you.
Like that.
We must reach the woods. Come. It's the lighthouse.
Let's try and make it over there.
Water!
Horses will never make that descent. We'll have to go on foot.
Get down!
Did you get down the cliff and outrun them?
No. Never make it.
It is time to stand and fight. Form behind me.
It'll make a good lookout.
Captain, why do we have to stay here and fight these people? We were ordered to find the blade and return it, nothing else.
I didn't notice that we had a choice. You're right about the blade. Somebody has to get it back. Mr. Burr, take this to Commodore Perry.
But how can I?
Because I ordered you to, that's how. Hold on to things here.
Come on, lad. The captain's right.
Uncle, I will.
Go on now. We'll meet up later.
And take this civilian with you. He's not qualified to die with samurai.
For the first time, it pays to be a fisherman.
When the Commodore asks about you, what should I say?
Tell him last you saw us, we were serving our country as we saw fit.
This sake? I could use some grog.
It is fuel to light the lamp. They light it during bad storms.
Just my luck.
Let's get some rest while we can.
Take first watch.
Aye, aye, sir.
Thank you.
しておる。
申し訳ありません。やつら土台の油に火をつけて
抗議。
Let's get out of here while they're regrouping.
Yes, sir.
You hang that bunch here, I'll take these in the back.
Getting up steam. They're leaving. Enduro will never make it.
Don't worry. The current is changing.
Great moment. Our countries are bound together.
Yes. I believe in my heart that this is the right thing to do for our people.
For some, it will be a very heavy price to pay.
Sir. Bushido blade.
Silly damn thing. We didn't even need it. Treaty was just signed.
Lord Yamato is dead. Prince Ito is dead. Haven't they had enough?
No. The code of Bushido says that they must die to the last man to avenge their lord.
Let's get on with it.
Foolish battles in wars without any meaning seems to be our fate. That man chose his own fate.
Mr. Burr, when you have changed into a proper uniform, I will be very pleased if you dine with me.
Was the squadron, Captain?
Yes.
Do you think they'll be back?
Yes, old friend, they'll be back. They'll all be back.